In lesson 3.3, a student volunteer picks up two buckets, one with a lot of water and one with a little water. This says 8 liters and 2 liters. It really doesn't matter, just so long as one has much more than the other. The student obviously realizes that the fuller one is much heavier, but the question for students is, does the water in both containers, both buckets, have the same density? We want kids to realize that density is a characteristic property of a substance, no matter how much you have. The other big idea here is that you can measure the density of a liquid like you measure the density of a solid, that all you need to know is the volume and the mass, and that the density of a liquid, in this case water, is related to the size, arrangement, and mass of the molecules that make it up, and that the density of water is 1 gram per cubic centimeter. So how do you get the density of 100 milliliters of water, 50 milliliters of water, and 25 milliliters of water? That's what kids do. They want to find the density of each amount. It's easy to get the volume. You just fill up a graduated cylinder up to 100. But to get the mass of the water, you need to know the mass of an empty graduated cylinder. So we go through this process with students, and they subtract the mass of an empty graduated cylinder from the mass of the graduated cylinder with water in it, and you end up with the mass of the water. Now, if you know the mass of the water and the volume, you can calculate the density. Density equals mass over volume. And what students will determine is whether they have 100 milliliters, 50, or 25. The density of the water is going to be the same every time. We have students make a graph to show that it's a nice straight line. If you have the volume on the x-axis and the mass on the y, you see that 25 milliliters of water has a mass of 25 grams. If you do the math, you end up with 1 gram per cubic centimeter. 50 milliliters of water has a mass of 50 grams. You do the math, and it also equals 1 gram per cubic centimeter. And the same with 100. So kids see this straight line relationship between the volume and the mass. That means regardless of the volume, you're always going to have a density of 1 gram per cubic centimeter. But why is that? The reason is because water is homogeneous throughout a sample. It's the size, arrangement, mass of water molecules is the same no matter where you go in the sample. So if you look at a sample of water like this and you know the mass and the volume, if you then take half the volume, you'll have half the mass because it's consistent throughout. That's true for any substance that's homogeneous throughout. On the activity sheet, we show students a sample A, for instance, that's 5 by 5 by 4, which means it is 100 cubic centimeters. And if it weighs 200 grams, you do the math, you get 2 grams per cubic centimeter. If you take sample A and cut it in half, so now you have half the amount of matter, you've got 5 by 5 by 2, so it's 50 cubic centimeters, but it must have half the mass because you have half as much stuff. But if you do the math, you end up with 2 grams per cubic centimeter as a density. It's going to be the same. And then again, if you cut that one in half, the density is constant. It's 2 grams per cubic centimeter. Now, if you're doing an activity about the density of water, you really can't avoid talking about ice. So if you freeze water and it becomes ice, it's less dense than the liquid water. That's because when you freeze water, the molecules become a crystal and they spread out a little bit and they take up more room than they did as liquid water. So you have the same mass, but it takes up more volume, so the ice is less dense than the water. Now, if you're in an NGSS state, the performance expectation, MSPS 1.1, says develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. This doesn't say anything about density, but we're using density as a context to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures in the case of ice. So you can describe molecules to students and they can learn about the atoms that make up molecules while covering density. In fact, if you look at the foundation boxes for this performance expectation, you'll see that students do exactly this. They develop models to describe phenomena, and they plan and carry out an investigation. In this case, the investigation is about the density of different volumes of water. Also, in structure and properties of matter, kids see that each pure substance has characteristic physical and chemical properties, in this case, physical properties of density. And for the cross-cutting concept of scale, proportion, and quantity, the idea is that students are looking at a macroscopic phenomena or characteristic like density and analyzing it all the way down to the molecules and using those different scales to understand this phenomena. So thanks for watching and good luck with the lesson.